Okay, I have resoldered all the connections between these two boards. So first I will add this adapter, which permits to have a 6 mm plastic tube. The pinout is here. I have identified all terminals of this connector. Plus 12, minus 12, I think it is plus 12, but it can be plus 15 or minus 15, I don't know, but I will use plus 12 volts. The output, the altitude rate is here. So the altitude, normally, the altitude is present on terminal K. The third output is this one, so I don't know exactly the purpose of this one. So now I will connect this thing to a power supply and to an air pressure generator. Let's see if the pressure is constant now. Okay. Currently the power supply is off, but the pressure seems constant. Okay, so let's turn on the power supply. At sea level, the voltage is close to minus 8.5 volts. The voltage is zero for a pressure of minus 0.55 bars or something like that. Minus 0.5 bars approximately. Okay, so the range seems to be minus 10 to plus 10 volts approximately. But it will be difficult for me to go below this pressure. It's difficult to go below minus 0.8 bars. This is the result of this sensor. On the x-axis, there is the altitude in 1000 feet. I have used the normalized table in order to convert the pressure into altitude for that purpose. And on the y-axis, there is the altitude voltage in volt. So you can see that from 0 to approximately 30,000 feet, this is perfectly linear. So the correction of linearity works perfectly. Above 30,000 feet, this thing is not linear anymore. So the limit of this instrument is something close to 30,000 feet. It should be possible to calculate the rate of change of this altitude. I have connected this transducer to this VSI indicator. This indicator was described in three of my previous videos. Number 110 to 112, so you can take a look if you want. This indicator is configured in ARINC 575 interface. The altitude rate output of the transducer is connected directly to the input of this instrument. We have seen with my previous calculations that this thing is compatible. The rate output is approximately 0.5 millivolts per feet, per second. This transducer is connected to an air pressure generator, which is just on the right here. And we can monitor the pressure with this manometer here. I will simulate a climb by decreasing the air pressure. Okay, so the pressure should decrease linearly with time. if we want to have a fixed position of the needle. I am going to simulate a descent now by decreasing the pressure in order to return to the normal pressure. One more time. This was the teardown, the reverse engineering and the test of this pressure head sensor. Thanks for watching and see you next time. Bye bye.